Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, you will learn how to customize the Syncfusion Blazor Carousel component. Look at this Blazor Carousel example. The previous and next navigators are shown in different colors, and the indicators are displayed with slide images. Also, the play button is added and customized. Now, I will show you the code to achieve this customization using an existing Blazor application. Let me open the Blazor Carousel application, where I have added the Blazor Carousel component with four image items inside the carousel item tags. Follow the link provided in the card and description below to learn the basics of adding a Blazor Carousel to an app. I run this example by pressing F5. Looking at the output page, the images are arranged like a typical slideshow. Notice here, by default, the images change automatically at a regular interval of 5 seconds. Suppose I want to change the interval of the slides. I would define the interval property with appropriate values. Here, I set the interval as 2 seconds. You can see that in the carousel component, the images now change at an interval of 2 seconds. In this example, the slides repeated continuously by default. If I want to disable the slide looping transition, then I need to define the loop property and set its value to false. Looking at the output page now, the slides are no longer repeating continuously. You can change the slide manually using navigators or the indicators. When changing the image slides, the slide animation is applied by default. But you can also apply the fade or none transitions. I will show you the fade option by defining the animation effect property with the value fade. Now, when I change the slide in the component, the fade animation effect is applied. Notice here, by default, indicator bars are shown in the carousel component. If I want to show a preview of a slide in an indicator, I need to use the indicator's template option. To do that, first, I need to add the carousel items within this child content to set the child content of the carousel component. Then, I define the indicator's template option and add a few HTML elements within it. I define the source attribute and add alternate names for the image element. To set the source path, first I need to access the image names. So, I define the list variable indicator's image name list with appropriate values to use these image names in the source attribute. Next, I set the source path for the image, using this indicator's image name list variable. I also define a few CSS styles for the indicators and add a custom border style for the currently active indicators within the style section. Looking at the output page now, the indicators are displayed with the slide images. Notice here, while changing the slide images, the border is shown in different color. By default, the indicators are shown in the component. If I would like to hide them, then I define the show indicators property with the value false inside the Blazor carousel code. See in the output page, the indicators are hidden. Next, I will show you how to customize the navigators in the carousel component. To do that, I define the previous button template and next button template tags within this Blazor carousel code. Then, I import the Syncfusion Blazor buttons namespace. And add the Blazor button code with CSS class property to use the button component here. I have assigned eOutline class to the CSS class property to set a transparent color for the buttons. Next, I plan to draw custom buttons for previous and next navigators, so let me define the SVG and path element with appropriate values. I also define a few CSS styles for the carousel navigators and change the image container styles. You can see in the carousel component, the customized navigators are displayed. Notice here, by default, navigators are visible all the time. Suppose I want to hide them or display them only while hovering over them. I can make use of the button visibility property to do this. To display the navigators while hovering over them, I define the button visibility property and set its value to visible on hover. And here, the navigators are visible while hovering over them. In this example, the image slide transitions are performed automatically. If I want to display a play button in the carousel component, I just define the show play button property and set its value to true within this Blazor carousel code. Now, there's a pause and play button in the carousel component. If I click the button, it changes to a paused state. Also, notice that when the carousel hits the last slide, the play button automatically gets paused, as the image looping behavior is disabled. Next, I will show you how to customize the play button using play template. To do that, I define the play button template tag within this Blazor carousel code. I am going to customize the play buttons using the Syncfusion Blazor button component, so I add the Blazor button code, as I have already imported Blazor button's namespace here. Next, I define a variable as slide play with the value true to change the button state value when play is clicked. To this button component, I set the title based on the isSlidePlay variable value. If isSlidePlay is true, the pause title will be set. And if isSlidePlay is false, then it will be set to play. Then, I will define isToggle property to true to toggle the button state. Now, I want to show a different button style for the play and pause states, so I am going to draw a custom button style for these buttons using the SVG element. First, I add an onClick event and assign the isSildePlay variable as not isSlidePlay. If the isSlidePlay variable value is true, then I will draw a pause button style using the SVG element and define appropriate path values in the path element. Similarly, I will draw a play button style within this else part. I need to assign this isSlidePlay variable to the autoplay property. I then define a few CSS styles for the carousel play and pause button. You can see in the carousel component that the pause and play button is displayed with a custom style. Right now, the image slide transitions are performed. To disable the auto slide transition, I can set the autoplay property to false within this carousel code. Also, I plan to hide the play button, so let me set show play button property as false. Now, you can see in carousel component that the image slide's auto transition is disabled. In this video, we have seen how to customize the appearance of Blazor carousel indicators and navigators using a template. We also saw how to hide them and how to add and customize a play button. If you would like to see the working example of the component used in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.